Saint-Gobain Finland proudly presents. Welcome to learn more about Saint-Gobain's operations in Finland and the world's first plant that processes and utilizes ladle slag generated in steelmaking. Welcome to witness an innovative step towards a circular economy in the construction industry and a reduction in carbon dioxide emissions from building materials. Welcome to be impressed and see how cooperation and ambitious goals can reduce carbon dioxide emissions by more than 20,000 tons per year in the Nordics in terms of a major manufacturer of building materials, the Saint-Gobain Construction Chemicals and Weber's Dry Mortars, and replace more than 70% of the virgin binders in building materials by utilizing industrial side streams. Here in Raahe, on the shores of the Bothnian Bay on Finland's northwestern coast, stands SSAB Steel Mill, which produces the world's best steel in the form of hot-rolled plates and strip products. The plot adjacent to the huge 500-hectare factory site now houses the world's first slag processing plant, where SSAB's ladle slag is processed and utilized in Saint-Gobain's cement-based products as an innovative binder, replacing traditional cement. But how did this incredible innovation come about?
So we started this project in year 2017 when we looked for alternative aggregate and fillers for our dry mortars. That was my first contact with SSAB, the steel producer here in Finland, and looking for slags that were not in use for other purposes. A couple of years later, we added also the binders into the project and called this the Alternative Aggregates and Binders Project. This was the first time I also was in contact with Oulu University and got a sample of a fine milled ladle slag sample from them.
Naturally, we here at the Saint-Gobain are super proud and excited about this project. The team at SSAB is just as thrilled about this circular economy lead.
Usually when people are speaking about this steel industry transition into fossil-free steel production, they tend to forget that alongside the steel production, we are also producing huge amount of byproducts, materials, not only CO2 gas. And we have to find also solution for those byproduct materials. And here in Raahe, we are really happy that we have managed to develop a system together with Saint-Gobain, who is in our neighbor now, and taking care of this ladle slag. It means that it's not only for us beneficial, because at the same time, we can have a good utilization for our ladle slag, and our customer Saint-Gobain can decrease their CO2 emissions.
The journey from an idea to a fully operational processing plant has taken 7 years. We have been working on the joint process with SSABs for 5 years. Along the way, we have also patented unique know-how related to products and the plant. As a curiosity, we can reveal that equipment and parts for the processing plant alone have been gathered from around the world from several different countries. Gunnar Forsman also spent hours tracking the journey of the grinding mill to Finland.
Finally, we ended up with a process that included parts delivered from both Finland, Europe, even Africa, and Asia to this part. It was a very interesting piece to piece this together, because the deliveries were quite long and you had to keep the time schedules so that they would all fit in at the right time when they arrived to the plant.
To satisfy your curiosity, we will now explain how the process works, how Saint-Gobain benefits from it, how SSAB benefits, and above all, how our more sustainably built planet benefits from it. Special cements made from limestone and bauxite were previously used as binders in the floor leveling compounds manufactured by Saint-Gobain. Among other slags, SSAB steelmaking process produces ladle slag as side product, which was previously used for soil improvement. Now metals are separated from the ladle slag produced in the final stage of SSAB steelmaking process and the remaining slag, in other words, the potential binder, is utilized in Saint-Gobain's dry mortars, replacing virgin special cement. Ladle slag pots are transported to Saint-Gobain's plants in large slag port carriers, from where the 400-degree slag is unloaded for pre-processing, after which the crushed slag is transferred by machine onto a cooling conveyor. Larger steel particles in the slag are recycled back to SSAB's steel mill. During cooling, the slag is screened, and the screened slag continues through the cooling line to silos. During the separation stage, the slag is rescreened, and the largest particles are transferred back to the line via a crusher. On the line, magnets separate steel particles of different sizes from the slag. The collected steel particles are recycled back to the steel. Next is the grinding stage, which takes place in a gigantic bowl. During grinding, processing and screening continue, and the finished product is transferred to product silos. The finest metal particles are separated from the recycled processed powder using magnets, and the metal is recycled back into the steelmaking process. The finished slag powder is transferred to silos and transported taken to Saint-Gobain's production plant. With this process, little slag can be fully utilized and no waste is generated in the process. Approximately two-thirds of the material arriving at the Raahe plant is recycled back into production at the SSAB steel mill as a reusable metal.
This is the first time ever that this has been put into reality. And it also means that this is the first plant. So we see a good potential for the future to develop this a little bit further and also to make use of other sources around the world or closer by. This has been a very tremendous trip for me myself, because we started from absolutely zero, where we didn't have a process, and then we started developing this all together, and we finally end up in a completely new plant that has never been built before. It's a very exciting story, really.
This same application can be utilized also in our future steel production, which means that the application which has been now developed together with Saint-Gobain is not only applicable for today's ladle slag, but also for the future ladle slag.
Saint-Gobain has invested around 13 million euros in the slag processing plant and its processes. The investment supports our goal of achieving net zero carbon emissions in Finland by 2035 and globally as Saint-Gobain Group by 2050. The value of SSAB's investments in our new joint process is approximately 2 million euros. And a big thank you to Business Finland and the European Union's Next Generation's EU funding. Our project has received funding of around 35% from the Sustainable Growth Programme for Finland. All this is just the beginning of a beautiful friendship, cooperation and a better tomorrow. We at Saint-Gobain and SSAB both have ambitious goals to expand our cooperation in the future for a more sustainable built environment.
So the solution which we have developed here in Raahe, it's also possible to utilize and copy to our other steelmaking facilities in Oxelösund and in Luleå. And we already have had discussions concerning this. So it means that we are not satisfied only what's happening here in Raahe, but we are also aiming to utilize all the results and good benefits from all of our steel production sites.
Thanks to our new innovation, we can now demonstrate a smaller carbon footprint for Weber INAI branded building materials by publishing environmental product declarations very soon. Because we are making the world a better home.